Welcome to the channel 3 Minute Study of Africa. Like and subscribe. In 2013, the British government publicly apologized for the atrocities it committed during its colonial rule of Kenya. British Foreign Secretary William Hague apologized to Congress, saying, "The British government is deeply sorry for the violence it committed to Kenya and for causing a setback to the Kenya independence movement." Kenya became a British colony in the late 19th century under the name of East Africa Protectorate. It was the result of Germany and Britain fighting over the territory of Kenya, and the British won. The Kenyans could not approve this. From 1952 until 1963, the Kenyans did not stop fighting against Britain, forming independence movement. This independence movement is called as Mau Mau Resistance. Mau Mau is an armed independence movement group created by Kenya's largest ethnic group, Kikuyu, and the others, especially those who were peasants. It is estimated that 90,000 people, many of whom were innocent, were killed, maimed, and 160,000 detained during the uprising after Britain declared an emergency and intervened in force. Britain had no choice but to allow Kenya's independence step by step. In 1955, the establishment of Kenyan political parties was allowed finally, but with only the rich holding key government positions and actual independence activists failing to participate in political reforms. But contrary to Britain's strategy to hand over their power to moderate Kenyan parties, the situation was reversed. The Kenyan African National Union, led by Jomo Kenyatta, won the election. Jomo Kenyatta became the first president of Kenya, of the independent Kenya. Since then, Kenya has made a lot of efforts to develop its current level of democracy. After the death of Jomo Kenyatta, who was the first president, in 1978, his son Daniel Arap Moi succeeded him as the next president and established a one-party dictatorship to serve 5 consecutive terms as president. That was a total of 24 years. On the other hand, the current president is Uhuru Kenyatta, who has been in office since 2017, and he was directly chosen by Kenyans without corruption. The rival of Uhuru Kenyatta in the election was Raila Odinga. Despite being elected, Uhuru Kenyatta had to hold another election because the opposition party demanded re-election from the Supreme Court. Fortunately, President Uhuru was elected in the second election again, and Uhuru Kenyatta also submitted evidence of his opponent's alleged wrongdoing and hacking for the election. The case of a Supreme Court invalidating the election results of a country is rare in Africa. I hope that Kenya's efforts for democracy will continue in the future.